Hello students, in this session we are going to continue our enthalpy change definitions ahead. So far we have found out the standard enthalpy changes of formation, combustion, fusion, evaporation, vaporization and including some dimension as well. So here in this we are going to start it with the standard enthalpy change of atomization. Standard enthalpy change of atomization. So when you talk about an atomization, it stands for atom formation. Atom formation, whatever the species you start with, it doesn't matter. But under standard conditions, we are doing this, carrying out, thinking about this enthalpy change only under standard, when the conditions are standard. So, it's to form one mole of gaseous atoms from any given species. It doesn't matter what's the species or what's the physical state of the species. We are going to break them all bonded. Means if it's a solid or liquid, even in gases as well, you could have intermolecular attraction forces as well as intramolecular bonding. So, we are going to break them all. So, breaking those all bonding, what we are going to form is one mole of gaseous atoms. Let's take a look at an example. Let's use H2 gas, hydrogen gas. So, according to our standard enthalpy change of atomization definition, it is, we are going to form one mole of hydrogen gaseous atoms. When you talk about atoms separately, those would be at gaseous state. That's obvious. So students, it's the enthalpy change taken place under standard conditions when you form one mole of gaseous atoms using any given species. So it is hydrogen H2 gas, the form given. So you need to form one mole. So you need to maintain one mole here. Then you need to balance accordingly the other side. It is one. So, then let's use another one, O2 gas, dioxygen. When it is the standard enthalpy change of atomization? The symbol standing for standard enthalpy change of atomization, writing atom here. So, it's when you talk about the standard enthalpy change of atomization of O2 gas, here H2 gas of O2 gas is the formation of one mole of gaseous atoms using even O2 gas. It's that easy. You could use not only O2 but also O3 gas. Then it is the standard enthalpy change of atomization atom of O3 gas. So it is still the formation of one mole of gaseous oxygen atom using that given one. It is then in the balanced chemical equation maintaining one here. It has three answers. So let's use another one, bromine, Br2. It's a liquid normally at room temperature, but whatever the physical state that it could be found out, it's you could decide what to be used at the beginning. You could use even BR2 gas. It depends. It depends on your requirement. So whatever it is, it doesn't matter the physical state or molecular form here you have, but it's a must giving one mole of gaseous atom. Fine. So the enthalpy change taken place for that is the standard enthalpy change of atomization. Then you need to clearly state for what it stands. It stands here for BR2 liquid. So if it is, then it is half. So let me erase this. It's when you go ahead with standard enthalpy change of atomization for further view, let's use a solid. It is, let's use P4 solid. The standard enthalpy change of atomization of P4 solid is giving P phosphorus gaseous atoms, one mole. So it is 1-4. It is the standard enthalpy change of atomization. So of P4 solid. Clear? So further, when it is a metal, let's say it's aluminium solid. When you talk about the standard enthalpy change of atomization of aluminium solid, it is the preparation of aluminium gaseous atoms using the given. So then it's balanced. So it's the standard enthalpy change of atomization of aluminium solid. For species like that, you might can see the similarity here. It's similar to the standard enthalpy change of sublimation of aluminium acid. Sometimes it could happen randomly like that. So students, here it's about bond breakage or attraction breakage. So therefore it's energy using process, means it's going to be endothermic. All the standard enthalpy changes of atomizations, students, would be endothermic.